Yeah. Quite some time. We'd like to play a very, 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 very old song. Now, some of you might not know this song, but this song is, in fact, well, this tour is almost the 10th anniversary of this song. It's almost 10 years old, and so we thought we'd renovate the old song, dust off the old 12-string guitars, dust off the old storybooks, and bring to you a piece of Genesis history. Now, this song has got lots of loud bits and lots of quiet bits. Lots of loud bits,
yeah,
and lots of quiet bits. Loud bits,
yeah,
and quiet bits. And so this old story that I was telling you about, you would like to hear an old story, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
You would like to hear an old story, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Right. Are you sitting comfortably? I shall begin. This, then, is the romantic story of two young lovers, Romeo and Juliet. Romeo, this hand over here, Romeo was 16 years old, and he was very, very fond of sexual stimulation. Juliet, over here, this hand, was also 16 years old,
yeah,
and very large in the upper regions.
Yeah.
Well, one day, Romeo, feeling like a bit of sexual stimulation, decided to telephone Juliet and ask her out to a drive-in movie. You still have drive-in movies in Phoenix, don't you? Well, then you'll know what I'm talking about. Well, Juliet, of course, accepted the kind invitation. And before long, Romeo had whizzed round in his father's car, and he picked Juliet up and drove with her to the drive-in movie. And there, at the back of the park, once the film had started, he started to heavily pet Juliet. Romeo wasn't getting very far like this, and so he decided to take more drastic action. So he ripped off her dress, and then carefully and quietly rolled down Juliet's stockings, and then finally removed her giant brassiere. Page 3. Well, Romeo quickly undid his own trousers and took them off. But, unfortunately for poor old Romeo, he had to do this act himself because Juliet, by this time, was, of course, tied to the steering wheel. And so, Romeo approached Juliet, and Juliet, from her crouched position by the steering wheel, took one look at that thing and said, "No, no, Romeo, don't come near me with it, please, I won't, I won't." Now, Romeo was, by this time, you must understand, very highly aroused. And so he said, "Juliet, Juliet, really, you cannot leave me like this." And Juliet, again, from her crouched position by the steering wheel, said, "No, no, Romeo, I really mustn't, I really can't, because you see, I just remembered that supper is ready."
Yeah!
Walking across the city, I tell you, sitting beside you, I look into your eyes, as the sound of motor cars leads in another time. I swear I saw your face change, but it didn't seem quite right. Thank you.
coming closer with our eyes. A distance falls around our bodies. Where are you now? The moon seems very bright. Six saintly shrouded, they move across the lawn slowly. The seven walks in front. The cross held high in hand, and it's, hey babe, your supper's waiting for you.
Orthodox glorious, standing still below the ground.
We watch in reverence, is not. Coliseum.